Hi, my name is Carly Rundle. I'm a second-year master's student with Dr. Hans Stein, and today I will be talking about the effects of Sangrovit Extra on apparent ileal digestibility of amino acids, crude protein, acid hydrolyzed ether extract, and starch by weanling pigs fed corn-soybean meal diets. I would like to begin with a brief overview of the issues surrounding weaning and an introduction to isoquinoline alkaloids, followed by a description of the materials and methods. Then I will go over the results from the experiment and conclude with a few take-home messages. Weaning exposes the piglet to an abrupt change in social interactions, including separation from the sow and mixing of litters. Nutritionally, piglets are switched from sow milk to less palatable, high-protein, high-carbohydrate, plant-based feeds with anti-nutritional factors. Additionally, there's a potential exposure to new diseases and the need for adaptation to new environmental conditions. This post-weaning stress results in many changes in the gastrointestinal health of the piglet, including an increase in the gastric pH, villus atrophy, and crypt hyperplasia in the small intestine, decreased absorptive capacity in the large intestine. This change in morphology results in a decreased ability to defend against pathogens and to digest and absorb essential nutrients. This reduced immunity can result in post-weaning diarrhea and decreased performance, including a decrease in feed intake and daily gain, and an increase in mortality and morbidity during the nursery period. Producers use antibiotic growth promoters to minimize the effects of post-weaning stress. However, antibiotic resistance concerns have been rising in humans and livestock due to this subtherapeutic dosage. In 2006, the European Union implemented a full ban on in-feed antibiotic usage in livestock, and in 2013, the United States issued guidance to phase out the use of medically important antibiotics in livestock for production purposes. Some alternatives include minerals such as zinc oxide and copper sulfate, probiotics and prebiotics, plant extracts, and acidifiers. For the purpose of this presentation, we will talk about one specific plant extract. Sangrovit Extra is a plant extract derived from Maclaea cordata, commonly known as the plume poppy. The primary active components in this plant are classified as isoquinoline alkaloids, which include sanguinarine, shelerothrin, protopine, and allocryptopine. Alkaloids in general are defined as nitrogenous organic compounds in plants that have pronounced physiological effects. Isoquinoline alkaloids have anti-inflammatory, immunomodulatory, and antimicrobial physiological effects. This includes a reduction in neutrophil viability, an increase in the expression of tight junction proteins, including ZO1 and Claudin-1, an inhibition of NF-kappa-B activation, which leads to a reduction in cytokine expression, and an inhibition of cell division in gram-negative and gram-positive bacteria, all of which could potentially lead to a reduction of post-weaning diarrhea and improved gut function. When used as a feed additive in livestock feeds, isoquinoline alkaloids increase serum amino acid levels in swine, specifically lysine and tryptophan, and increase the total tract digestibility of nitrogen in diets fed to steers. In growth performance trials, isoquinoline alkaloid supplementation increased average daily gain, average daily feed intake, and gain-to-feed ratio in swine and poultry. However, there is minimal information on the effects of IQ on the digestibility of specific nutrients in swine. Therefore, the objective of the experiment is to test the hypothesis that isoquinoline alkaloid supplementation in corn-soybean meal diets increases the apparent ileal digestibility of amino acids, crude protein, acid hydrolyzed ether extract, and starch when fed to weanling pigs. Now, I will move on to a brief overview of the materials and methods. Using a randomized complete block design, there were 4 treatments and 8 barrels per treatment. 4 experimental diets were formulated with corn, soybean meal, soybean oil, lactose, and fish meal as the primary components. All diets were formulated to contain the same metabolizable energy and standardized ileal digestible lysine. The control diet contained no IQ, and subsequent diets were formulated to contain 90, 180, and 360 milligrams per kilogram IQ at the expense of corn. We used 32 ileal cannulated barrows with an average initial body weight of 12.19 kilograms. Ileal digesta were collected by attaching a bag to the outer portion of the T cannula, shown on the left, that was surgically inserted into a distal ileum, shown on the right, for 8 hours each collection day. Pigs were fed ad libitum for a 12-day adaptation period, followed by a 2-day collection. These same pigs then remained on the same diet for an additional 12 days, followed by another 2-day collection. Contrast statements were used with coefficients for unequally spaced treatments in order to determine the linear and quadratic effects of IQ on the apparent ileal digestibility of crude protein, amino acids, acid hydrolyzed ether extract, and starch within each collection period. Results obtained from collection period 1 were also compared with results from collection period 2 using repeated measures analysis. Now let's move into the results. I would like to begin by setting up the slide. On the x-axis, we have the inclusion of Sangrovit Extra, or IQ, in milligrams per kilogram, and on the y-axis, we have the apparent ileal digestibility of starch. Period 1 digestibility is represented by the orange bars, and period 2 digestibility is represented by the blue bars. As we can see, there is a quadratic effect on the apparent ileal digestibility of starch in period 1, with the highest digestibility seen in the 90 milligrams per kilogram treatment. Additionally, there was a tendency towards a quadratic increase in the digestibility of starch in period 2, with these values being significantly lower than in period 1. At this time, no published research exists to explain this finding. There were no linear or quadratic effects of IQ on the apparent ileal digestibility of crude protein. However, digestibility of crude protein was higher in period 2 than in period 1. As the apparent ileal digestibility of crude protein is also higher in the control diet, this study was not able to distinguish whether this increase was a result of prolonged IQ inclusion or simply due to a natural increase in digestibility as pigs mature. When examining the effects of IQ inclusion on the apparent ileal digestibility of all indispensable amino acids, we can see that there was a quadratic increase with the highest value again observed in the 90 mg per kilogram treatment. As with crude protein digestibility, the apparent ileal digestibility of indispensable amino acids was higher in period 2 than in period 1. Again, we are unable to determine to what extent IQ inclusion plays a role in this increase. Now, looking at the apparent ileal digestibility of dispensable amino acids, we can see that there were no linear or quadratic effects. However, the digestibility was higher in period 2 than in period 1, as seen previously. Specifically in period 1, we observed a quadratic effect on the apparent ileal digestibility of threonine, tryptophan, and valine, with the greatest increase in digestibility in the 90 mg per kilogram treatment. There was also a tendency for a quadratic increase in the digestibility of methionine. However, this result did not reach significance. Although we did examine the effects of IQ on the apparent ileal digestibility of acid hydrolyzed ether extract, those results were not significant. To conclude, the inclusion of isoquinoline alkaloids led to an increase in the AID of specific indispensable amino acids and an increase in the AID of starch. We also observed a change from period 1 to period 2 in the AID of starch, crude protein, and amino acids. However, the reason for this change is unclear. Apparent ileal digestibility of starch and amino acids is increased by the addition of IQ to corn-soybean meal diets, most significantly at 90 mg per kilogram, and thus, diets may be formulated with IQ in order to increase the digestibility of nutrients in the weanling pig diet. I would like to thank Phytobiotics for funding this research, and I would also like to thank my lab group for their continued guidance and support. If you want to know more about what research our lab is doing, please visit nutrition.ansi.illinois.edu. Thank you for your attention.